Okay, so today I'm going to do a step-by-step tutorial of how to start your swamp milkweed seeds. I got these from edenbrothers.com, and I paid full price for everything we're going to show here today, but I'm going to review the Park Seed Double Biodome, and that's what this kit is. This is the biggest biodome setup that they have, so if you want to start your seeds in the wintertime, or in this case, it's actually summertime, and I'm starting them a little late, but I'll explain that as we go. Comes with complete instructions. This thing has polystyrene inserts that you can put your seed pods in, and the pods are unique too. But we'll go over step by step, look at it really close here. This polystyrene stuff is made in Canada, as you can see here. Plug block, it's called, and it holds 40 plugs. So there are two of them. This is an 80 plug system made by Beaver Plastics Limited, and it has a special sealant so it does not absorb water, even though it's going to be in water for an extended period of time. So these things are really cool. Little tougher than your normal polystyrene here. We're also going to put these really cool bio sponges in that come with it, and they're in these Ziploc bags. They're already pre-moistened. And what's in that? Well, according to a guy named Steve at the Park Seed Company, these are made from fir bark compost, peat moss, and there's a polymer binder that gives it its sponginess. So these things are pretty good. They're going to hold a lot of moisture. And guess what? We're just going to drop a seed in each one, and we're going to use this to germinate our seeds. And I'm going to show you everything, including how to plant them outside, if you'll watch to the end. So we just put them all in here. Now I rethought this a little later. Maybe it would be easier to keep track of which ones you dropped your seeds into if you kept these little pods out, the bio sponges. Each of them has a hole in the center, so when you drop the seed in, if you don't keep track, you won't know which one you've seeded. So I thought if I did it again, I would just drop the seeds in the sponge and then put the sponge into the block. And this is a close-up of the seeds. I'm going to look for really good plump ones to put in because I'm only putting in one seed per bio sponge. And here they are. I left them on the top so I could see them all. And then once I put them in, of course, there are 80 total. I'm going to push them in just a little bit. And just below the surface, and guess what happens? It's going to pull water up from underneath. You also get this packet of food, and it needs a quarter teaspoon per gallon. And I'm going to use 1 gallon to fill this tray. And we're not going to pour the water over the top of it. We're going to pour the water into the basin, and then we're going to float these little bio block support systems here. And again, there's two of them. These come in different sizes. You can get a 60, a 40, or an 18, and these are the two 40s. And also you can get different size biodomes too. This is the biggest one and the tallest because I wanted it to accommodate the seedlings once they grow and I didn't want them bending over and hitting the top. So these are floating. Can you overwater it? Nope. Because once you put the water in, the polystyrene holders there raise up with the water and they just keep it moist. It wicks it up from underneath. So this is pretty cool and you're not gonna run out of water. And don't water from the top, water from the bottom. And because we're just starting them out, we're going to close these vents off. And do we need daylight to start them off? Nope, they can start in the dark. So, and I kept it between 75 and 80 degrees during the germination period. And in the meantime, I went outside to prep my site for my future seed planting when these things germinate. So I'm planting swamp milkweed, so I have this nice damp soil area. And what I'm looking at is the site that used to be my goat compost pile. So this was composted 4 years ago. It's had plenty of time to break down, so it's not hot. And I think this is a great spot to start my seeds. So I threw down some heavy gauge black trash bags here and a mason board over there that's for concrete work, just to see if I could kill off some of the grass underneath for an experiment. Now once the seeds have germinated, this is 12 days in, I put them in this butterfly habitat. And that does a couple of things. One, it keeps birds and stuff out of my little seed blocks if I want to put them outside. And it cuts down some of the direct sunlight in the afternoon there. So it's a little shade, plenty of venting, and I can put them outside without worrying about anything bothering them. Even the honeybees tried to come up and drink water out of the sponges when they were uncovered. But you can see most of them have germinated. We got over 90% germination from these seeds. Now look, we jumped ahead. This is the 22nd day. And look how tall everything is. And I've been replenishing this with fish tank water. You can see that these bio sponges have stayed moist, that the growth is good, and by the way, they're not very leggy because we've been putting them out in full sunlight for 2/3 of the day. This porch, of course, is shaded in the afternoon, but these have come up great. And I would say, yeah, I think only like 7 of them did not germinate. So this is a really great experiment. And now we're out here at the planting plot. Pulled all the plastic, gonna pull all the plastics off here. And of course, I find a little snake underneath of them. Don't be scared, it's just a brown snake. Northern brown, and these things eat worms and bugs and other things, so they're very easygoing, and you definitely want these in your garden. So I'm just gonna let this little guy go. It looks like a baby snake, but it's actually an adult. Now we pulled up the tray here and look underneath. We can see that the roots have come out, and the dark circles here are the actual biosponges, and we just push them out from underneath. And look at the root growth. It's very nice. So they're not root bound. They have lots going on here, but it's ready to go in the soil for sure. And I did weed whack and work the soil just a little bit here before we put them in. And here we've planted more than 70 little seedlings. So that's fantastic. This is day 22. Don't forget to put some kind of animal repellent down. This critter ritter stuff is something I'm evaluating right now. Smells strongly of pepper. And I put this around because I don't want my dog digging through it. I don't want anybody marking the territory. And we don't want anything rooting around where our seedlings are going to be. So these milkweeds are going to actually grow, and the root systems are going to continue to develop through the year. We won't see any flowering this year, but it's going to carry them out through the winter time. So in the spring, I'll have this really cool milkweed patch for my pollinators, and of course, primarily the honeybees. So I hope you enjoyed watching this and found it helpful. All the stuff that I've shown you here today will be down in the video description, and you can follow the links to get one of your own. I think the biodome is fantastic, and as I mentioned before, this is not a promotion from the company. I paid full price for everything. You can save some money on these by buying through Amazon if you're an Amazon member. Then just get them. Thanks for watching, and always don't kill those reptiles when you find them in your garden. Let them go. They are excellent pest control. Have a great day, and happy planting for your honeybees.